Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and I lead the India and Emerging Markets for OneConnect Financial Technology. COVID is one of the biggest challenges of our lifetime and we all are hoping that we can go back to normalcy very soon. We all spoke about artificial intelligence, machine learning, data and need for digitalization, but we never imagined that 4 months will bring transformative changes in organizations where a digital decision could have taken more than a year. That has been the impact of COVID. Banking and financial industry represents the backbone of the economy. People are dependent on this ecosystem for day-to-day life, be it money transfers, loan, remittances, insurance. Customers look for simplified processes to solve their basic problems in life, and hence the need for transformation in this system is critical. Today, I would like to talk about three broad areas where technology can be the enabler for financial services firms. The first is ability to acquire and onboard customers swiftly by removing multiple customer touchpoints. The second is ability to analyze massive amount of data in seconds to improve risk decision making and keep the NPAs lower. And lastly, and the most important aspect is ability to improve customer service by improving agent productivity and capacity. And to do all this at 10x scale while serving customers not only from the top of the pyramid, but the bottom of the financial pyramid, which we call as financial inclusivity. Let us first talk about customer acquisition and onboarding. A simple KYC combines FR and OCI technology to onboard the customer, but it's job half done as you miss critical opportunity to do an upfront risk management with advanced technologies. At the same time, you end up creating multiple touch points with customers to ask information along the way. Today, KYC is being transformative and it is possible to solve many customer touchpoints on one platform. Let me give an example. You start the video KYC platform with agent and customer. Customer application form documents like ID card is available as inputs. Basis of customer application form, smart questioning is triggered. This is automated as an example based on geolocation. Nearest hospital can be questioned. This is to verify authenticity of the applicant's information. Platform is pre-integrated with not only facial recognition and OCR, which are basic technologies, but also micro expression and voice analysis, which is advanced technologies. A combination of technologies can identify deep fake across multiple levels. Let's give an example. Facial identification matches ID cards with selfies and also checks liveness detection. Today, deep fake allow liveness score to pass. You need the best FR technology in the market to mitigate this. OCR card reading is simple, but fraudsters use fake ID cards and fake photos on cards to submit applications. Using card level anti-fraud like hologram checks, landmark checks, and fake photo edge detection, these frauds can be mitigated. More advanced technologies like micro expression, emotion analysis can be used to identify emotions in the interview. When combined with smart questioning, this can be a very powerful tool to find risk of applicants where supporting documents may not be available. Advanced biometric analysis can be used to spot fraudsters who may come with fake IDs but cannot fake earlier recorded voice print. Together with all the checks, an instant multi-factor authentication risk score is provided online on agent screen. If applicant risk is high or anomalies are detected, agent can ask follow-up deep dive questions immediately in the same interview itself and make decisions. You close the interview and process the application and no further touch point with customer is required. The future of digital KYC is just not to meet the regulatory checkpoint, but also combine risk management upfront. Today, we have technologies and platform which can deliver this. The second important part of customer journey is risk management. Risk management is one of the core business functions for any financial services firm. The impact of digital fraud can erode your bottom line as well as top line. AI and machine learning can be used to identify frauds. Some I have already discussed during the KYC process. I will expand on some more technologies which can give additional layer of protection. One such technology is device fingerprint, or we call it as device intelligence. As mobile phones become more mainstream, it can be a source to identify fraudsters. Data points like battery life, number of loan application installs, SMS history, geo and IP tracking, syndicated fraud with multiple SIMs can now be discovered using device analysis. The second important aspect is device behavior analysis, which is the ability to track user behavior like typing speed, screen orientation, screen time, to filter anomalies in behavior and find out if someone else is using applicant's device. The other important part is alternate scoring models, using non-traditional data outside of credit scores to profile a customer, using SMS payment history reminders, bill payment history, e-commerce transactions, and third-party blacklist integrations. You not only need technologies to do this, but skilled data scientists are required who have experience in alternate data modeling. And these skills today are very, very hard to find and they are very expensive as well. To mitigate this issue, you can actually use third-party risk as a service partners who can help you accelerate the innovation in this area. One last example on the risk management is on general insurance car side. We can do damaged part image recognition analysis by using computer vision. This is becoming critical and can be very powerful when combined with anti-fraud and anti-leakage rules, and together can minimize the claim loss ratio. Having just technology is not sufficient to identify frauds. You need domain experience and years of data science skills to analyze information at scale. Partnership with firms who already have data models can give you a head start instead of starting things from ground zero. The last thing that I would like to touch upon is the customer servicing. And this is probably the single most critical layer to drive customer retention and satisfaction. As more and more transactions are becoming online, the load on call centers are increasing, and combined with high attrition and lack of agent training, the issue gets compounded. There are two aspects to solve here. The first one is improve call center capacity and wait times. And the second is big area to solve is how to improve agent productivity and skills to help them give better customer service. Let's take the first one, which is improve call center capacity and wait times. The customer wait time to get to an agent is sometimes greater than 5 minutes. And then customers spend close to 1 to 2 minutes in customer verification, depending on how easy it is for client to remember and obtain the information. Using voice identification, the customer verification is instant. This not only reduces overall wait time at the call centers, but also a big boost to customer satisfaction ratings. VoiceSprint technology is language agnostic and has very high match rate. Other critical area to optimize agent capacity is like automating the outbound calls. And as an example, today agents are actually manually calling your customers for payment reminders. This can be done through voice bots. Together with speech-to-text and conversational AI capabilities, this can free up a lot of call center time and help companies in collection process as well. Coming to the second part of customer servicing, which is improving the agent productivity. For agent-led processes that we see in life insurance business, customer service, and inside sales, the quality of agent is very critical. And it takes a lot of effort to train and retain the best agents. Automation can be used to drive online agent training via micro-expression bots. AI skill assessments are done so that the best agents are categorized by performance, so that focused trainings and upskilling can be delivered on an ongoing basis. Basis of this segmentation, top agents are mapped to high net worth individual customers for higher conversion and satisfaction rates. Given most of these agents are on contract basis, this focused approach on agent training reduces the agent attrition from all the way high up to 25% to less than 10%. In my closing remark, I would just like to add that AI takes time to mature, so it's critical to focus on the right data sets for training and partnership with firms which have already done modeling at scale. This will fasten your go-to-market. Domain expertise of insurance, lending, and banking is critical. Only tech focus will not help in benefit, and continuous learning is needed for any AI to succeed. The other important area is change management, both at business process and people level. With right focus on technology and process and people, financial services firm can deliver transformational experience to end customers and be future ready to compete with the big tech companies. Thanks a lot for your time and stay safe.